If you and your organization rule the world with your banks, Freemason and military Templars wing, then you need a tradition and teach future's next generations of pharaonic offspring. Therefore, the Swiss Templars of Octagon have their children brought up and indoctrinated into the visual world of secret symbology. It's all over. Like on the Swiss Army knife. It's all over here. So the Swiss ordered the Scandinavian toy factory called Lego to produce toys with the Templars' coat of arms on it, as you can see here. So when later they've become Swiss criminal banksters, they'll know for what and whom they work for. As in this construction game, like the Freemason Guild of Constructors and Masons who want to construct the New World Order, Reign of Evil of Seton, the Egyptian Lord of Darkness. This is why it shows the coat of arms of the Templars and their banks, as if it were the gold winners podium of the Olympic Games with their equally Vetica Peitsche's Freemason logo. So this is the Templars knife with the logo, the Swiss Army knife that probably stole the idea to make this steel from somebody else. The same logo as everywhere else. This is for children, so they get used to it. Look, it's fixed, you see, it's not a sticker or something. It's fixed. Yeah. And this is the Lego game. Yeah. It says Loge. L-E-G-O or L-O-G-E. That means a lodge. A Freemason lodge. It's an anagram. So here children can build, you know. So they can put it, you probably know this stuff. So now it's fixed with this system here. So this is especially for the Templars kids here in Switzerland. Loge. The Templar symbol on it. As on the knife, it's all over. Same stuff here. Mm-hmm. And here. So the word Lego, it says Loge, L-O-G-E, the same letters to all Masons. And Loge is the French word for lodge, as the similar pronunciation shows. And the first Templars spoke French from the French-speaking town of Sion, from Octagon, Switzerland. See my video about that. So the anagram of Lego, using the very same letters, is Loge, a lodge of the Mason Templars and Octagon. So this one here, for the kiddies to play with, it's called the Swiss Chalet. Like the one I filmed in Stade, where Polanski, the pedophile, is living. So here it says Swiss Chalet, the same one as Podolansky lives in. Similar. So you see the connection here. Children, Swiss Chalet, Polanski. Well, it's all there, folks. Nice, isn't it? Swiss Chalet, Polanski, pedophiles, children, Lego, Loge, Freemasons, Lodge, it's all there. And the same Lodge or Loge company for children to play with. They also make these little Templars here. As the Templars cross, you could see the Swiss Templars cross, the coat of arms on their Lego stuff. So this is Lodge, Loge, Swiss Chalet, Templars. And there's another one. Isn't it lovely? Lego, Loge, Lodge, what more to say? And this is why Alex Jones is putting this Swiss Templars logo all over his website and YouTube channel lately, to indicate all members that he's one of them. as a protection, not to hurt him and his family when civil war breaks out. And civil war they're aiming at after the Mason slogan Ordo ab Chaos. Make chaos and disorder first to rebuild after and install order for the order. A pity really that they want chaos and civil war just at this crucial moment on which the CIA, NSA and IRS are doing a great job in bringing down one Swiss Templars bank after the other, where Edward the Snowjob was assigned to do this in Geneva, Switzerland, in Octagon, but got the orders of his real masters of Octagon, the financial elite and the fair aristocracy, to quit the job and go to Russia. Because the intelligence services have to be stopped from poking around too much into the very circles of power. See my film on the snow job. Finally, the agency and a handful of incorruptibles are doing the job for which they are actually being paid for, instead of spying on us, the people. They gather intel on these lying politicians as German Chancellor Angela Merkel, and they already brought down two Swiss Templars banks. Game over for Bank Vigelin, the oldest bank of Octagon, Switzerland. So now, all of a sudden, they call it a rogue agency that has to be brought down by politicians and the United Nations using their mainstream media to manipulate public opinion, to incorporate us into their scam against the agency that has grown out of control, even attacking their own masters now. Please, people, wake up and don't let this happen. This is a very crucial moment. They try to mobilize us with their mainstream media. So, for at least 70 years, since 1945, the agencies have been spying on us, the people. And all the time nobody cared about that. No politician and no newspaper, media or TV, radio station. And now that apparently some elements within the agency have woken up and spy on their own masters, they say the agency has gone rogue and must be stopped. And in order to do that, they try to mobilize us, the people, to do that for them. But they will always spy on us after. This can be a turning point, folks. Something big is happening here. And Bill Cooper was right all the time about the AJ demagogue with his Templars logos all over. If we stop the agency now from the great job they're achieving, then they will be spying us again, 10 times as bad, after it has been cleaned up by the enemy within. And AJ, who wants a civil war, so he and his Swiss Octagon Templars can reposition afterwards. I have no doubt whatsoever whom Alex Jones is really working for and who his real masters are. He's working for a foreign power trying to discredit his own government, of which some of them are doing a damn good job at the moment. And the symbols don't lie and show the way. I wish I could tell Bill Cooper to tell him. Me, myself, I don't like governments. So I'm not trying to protect any government. We have to see clear here. And what I even dislike even more are these control agents who are actually working for the government. So, again, I don't like governments and what they're doing, but we have to differentiate. There are some good things going on. I'd like to tell Bill Cooper that I understand why they killed him, because me too, I'm getting murder threats by the Swiss Nazi police and the fascist authorities. All the time I get arrested while they try to lie something together in order to put me away. They planted drugs in my belonging, which I found out in time. They arrested me with a terrorist squad in 2011, putting 3 guns on my head, shouts, threats, hooded and armed men all over. They dragged me in front of the corrupt Freemason psychiatrist, Kurt Kunz, who lied 19 pages together about how crazy I am and how and should be locked up forever. They've put me away in high security prisons and forced labor camps for a year. And now these Swiss Nazi Templars want to put me in prison again after 2 entire days in their Nazi court on November the 26th and 27th, where they have accumulated a telephone book thick with their lies, like their aggressive Nazi cop Hans Rudolf Kühne hitting me. And I have to go to prison for that, because a cop hits me and I filmed it. And a prison sentence for putting videos on YouTube, which are in fact under the laws of the United States, where it was published in San Bruno, in fact entirely out of the jurisdiction of Octagon Switzerland. But here they don't care about any laws.
So it says November the 26th and November the 27th. I have to listen for 2 whole days to their next lies, and I can't do anything. I can't make a complaint, nothing. They won't talk about torture, terror, police aggressions, nothing. Just another complaint and another complaint and another attack. And they just lie to put the foreigner away. And here it says, if I don't put away my YouTube videos, which I don't put there for fun, I put them there in my own defense, you know, because it's wrong what they're doing. It's very criminal. It's total terror. So I'm not going to take them off. Anyway, it's under the laws of the United States. I published it in San Bruno. It's out of the Swiss jurisdiction. They've got nothing to So for their terror, they even want me to pay thousands of francs. Well, I don't even have any money. I don't know where to get that from. I've got holes in my shoes, I've got holes in my pants. I have no income. You can see the Swiss Nazis, they love money and more and more and more. They use it as a means of terror. Yeah. Yeah. So I have to pay for their terror on me. You know, it's unbelievable. Well, this is the home of the Nazis. And this has been going on for 16 long years. And it's not ending yet. It goes on and on. I have only YouTube. I've got nothing more here. Just YouTube. I can't drop a complaint. They won't even treat it. You know. So this is the Nazi country of Switzerland. So this is a whole phone book full of their lies, you know, just plain lies. And with this they want to reason and give a reason for their terror and their police actions, like sending a terrorist squad. They reason it, you know, with lies. The whole country is based upon lies, upon lies, upon lies. And they got their dirty little fingers in any crime in the world. This is the base of evil. I know these people now. They're extremely evil. Extremely. A bunch of assassins. And they killed many immigrants here. There's a whole list. Many people disappeared here. They even take on the US, the CIA, and you know, because of their banks. And now they try to mobilize the us, you know, the public opinion against the CIA. So they stop sniffing into the Swiss banks. That's what it's all about. You know, the snow job is it's just a psyop. He's part of it. He's part of Octagon. Those are his true masters. So I hope that the CIA and the NSA, that they snap him very soon and make him talk. because he's not fighting for us. Oh no, he isn't, Mr. Snowjob.
The last 2 years I've lived under constant house arrest, sneaking out like a thief in the night, because the Nazi police of Octagon tries to hang on things on me. They kidnapped my child and tortured me with code O2T, through which they murdered many immigrants here in Switzerland. Oh yes, Bill, I know what terror is for speaking out and for discovering too much. I've lived under constant terror here for 16 long years in this Nazi state of Switzerland. Yes, Bill, you were right all the time about Alex Jones, who never gets arrested and never has lawsuits. And in fact, since I made this film about Jones showing the Octagon symbols, all my new uploads get censored and blocked immediately. Too bad, Bill. I never could have talked to you and give you my intel about the heart of evil, Octagon in the Alps, and how AJ talks positively about Switzerland of the Nazis while showing their flag all over. Even in this video. Well, this is not the red cross here. InfoWars, you see? And well, this is the Swiss flag, the Templars flag. It's not a red cross, it's a white cross. It has nothing to do with the American Red Cross, which is in fact the same origin anyway. But this is the flag of Switzerland. And he has a couple of bells there. I'll tell you about that, about Alex Jones's pals. This is Alex Jones. This video is against the flu shot. Well, of course, it's not good, the flu shot and all these vaccinations. But the thing is, they want to take control. Our movement of the people is being infiltrated and it's a takeover. That's what it's about. Of course I'm against the government and their lies and their wars and their politicians and their tax evasion. But this is about taking over, as the Nazis did, you know. Well, he has ties to the Nazis. I show it to you now. And how positive AJ talks about Dominik Bettig of the Swiss People's Party here in 2011, who attends Nazi conferences all over Europe as he speaks both French, English and German. This guy probably is the most dangerous Nazi in Europe. Speaking for Switzerland, being its delegate and keeping a low profile behind the screens, just as the Swiss general Ulrich Wille, who financed Adolf Hitler in 1923. Oh, here's in Wikipedia. There he is. So this guy, this Nazi here, is a member of Swiss Parliament, and he's spreading his evil words all over Europe and the world probably. He's a part of the Swiss People's Party, so you know he doesn't like foreigners and immigrants. The guy is a psychiatrist, just as this Yugoslav dude, I don't know, who murdered a lot of people apparently. So this Dominik Bettig, he's got full protection of the Swiss people, of the Swiss government, the Swiss Justice Department, and of course of the Swiss police. We're all Nazis. And he's probably the most dangerous neo-Nazi or Nazi in Europe, spreading his evil things all over. And of course, as Switzerland always is, they tend to stay behind the screens and let the others do it, you know. Fortunately, the Germans are tired of marching, and the Swiss, they're not brave enough to do it themselves. Well, they do actually, but they're not in the open. They murder a lot of people here. And it was also the Swiss financial and weapons transactions with the Nazis that prolonged World War II with at least 2 years and two more hard winters in the forest for the Bielski partisans and the children and the women. So here I showed it in many of my films. It's a very important picture of Mr. Hitler in Zurich in 1923 when the Swiss Nazi Templars financed him with $500,000 today's worth. And here's the Swiss Nazi general Ulrich Wille, who did most of the transactions and the dealings with Mr. Hitler as a delegate for the entire Swiss population. Nice, charming, isn't it? Look at it. So these guys are the ones behind it all. And now, 70 years later, we got YouTube and all that. And we shouldn't forget the Bielski brothers and all those other victims and of these ones here. It's time to sort it all out. And I'm doing it. The best way to control the opposition is to lead it ourselves, Lenin. Well, Lenin, he lived in Zurich, Switzerland. I mean, the whole way Hitler came to power through using democracy is a very typical Swiss tactics of approach. Slow and thorough, never letting go the real objectives. Always when we, the people, have a movement going, cooking and going on against our masters of the aristocracy, they will join, infiltrate and finally get control over our movement. They did this with Christianity and the Church. National Socialism, a movement for and by the German people against hunger and abuse, which Hitler infiltrated, took over and turned it into an elitist party against the German people. Communism, against the feudal system of these pharaonic tsars who had Russian children starved to death and the rest of the Russians. It got infiltrated and turned over against the Russian people, simultaneously revenging the death of the Tsar family, for which millions of Russians had to pay dearly. And now we have the Truth Movement, infiltrated and taken over by Alex Jones, because they prefer their man telling us the things we want to hear, thus being able to exert more control with the possibility to mix it with lies, making a list just as the Nazis and the Bolsheviks did, and even make a load of money, eh? This is what they always do with all our movements, and Alex Jones is a shouter, a screamer and a demagogue, just as Hitler. They're both very rich, sell themselves as a man of the people, while stocking piles of money and both showing the symbols of octagon of the Templar, their base. And here's the other screamer, the other shouter, selling the same product and the same tactics, really. Just shouting and screaming. Hitler didn't want to pay taxes as the rest of the people and had 40 million euros today's worth at the end of the war. So he has all the reason to smile, eh? This is a smiling millionaire. Well, the aristocracy actually never paid any taxes, eh, Mr. Hitler? The aristocracy only collects the taxes, which is their invention from the beginning. Furthermore, indicating where Hitler's true roots lay. Yes, the aristocracy. And AJ InfoWars Prison Planet is the same. Selling us his alchemy brew bottles and making lots of money by selling us info that we the people found out ourselves, actually. The aristocracy also officially changed their names just like that. Just as French President Nicolas Sarkozy, whom you can see here, changed his name into Nico Sarkozy, spelling S-A-R-C-O-S-I, while he was living in Corsica. Just as AJ, most probably is Bill Hicks, or even Lafayette, and part of the royal fair aristocracy, and most certainly practicing tax evasion with his good pals from Octagon, Switzerland, from the Swiss People's Party, like the Betty guy, which flag he shows all over his bottles and InfoWars logo, showing his true colors of the fair aristocracy. So here we can see the young Sarkozy in his castle. Look at that. Well, he's part of the fair aristocracy. They even have a castle in Hungary. In Hungary. Yeah. Sar, it means the king in Pharaonic, like in a sarcophagus. This is aristocracy, guys, or pharaohocracy. So here's another picture of young Mr. Sarkozy. Already in politics. This was in 1975. So he was already mayor in Neuilly, in Paris, when he was only 28. Can you imagine? We, the people, when we are 50 or 60, we're still being treated as infants and nothings. They always change their names, just like that. He changed it officially, can you imagine? Just as Bill Hicks and Lafayette and Sarkozy, and they're standing above all laws. Well, you can read in French how he changed his name. It was even in the phone book. Yeah. Sarkozy. He just changes his name. Well, sounds more Corsican. Well, they are. This is the type of people who are ruling us. The fair aristocracy. And the fair aristocracy is the aristocracy of the pharaohs. Their royal blood per a bloodline. Lafayette. Hey. My videos and information are free, and you may all copy, download and re-upload them for our freedom and our future. I don't want your money while all my trousers and shoes are having holes in them. I want justice for humanity and our children. Hitler was more a calculating businessman than a man of and for the people. He made millions with the book Mein Kampf, with cards and photographs. He owned several Mercedes cars, airplanes, houses, lands, factories and artwork, for which he even had paid. All this while his beloved Germany lived in misery, enabling him to make a fortune through misery. There are proofs on YouTube about Hitler surviving in Argentina after the war, actually. So both Hitler and AJ have ties to Switzerland. And they show the Templar symbol and pharaonic stuff. Oh yeah, the French Revolution, by the way, is another example of a people's movement turned bad, infiltrated, taken over and finally directed against the people as an instrument of terror, with guillotines, heads chopped off one after the other, and giving Pharaoh Napoleon a chance to bring war over Europe. So it was a movement in the beginning by the people, just as National Socialism, Communism, InfoWars, everything, and then it got infiltrated and used against us, where there were all cleansings going on, just as you can see the cleansings here. It's always the same thing, actually. Hitler did it, you know, and then and there. Bye-bye, game over. Some people find it suspicious that AJ never talks about the Jews. Well, I guess that all these previously targeted peoples and ethnic minorities, as the Indians, the Redskins, the Japs, the Communists, the Gypsies, the Dacha people, the Celts, the Jews, the Tutsis of Rwanda, etc., etc., already had a shitload full of death, terror and murder that will last for a while. And the fair aristocracy rather focuses on Islam and the Muslims on their hit list at the moment. I can already tell you that the Chinese will be next. Remind you that AJ never says a bad word about Switzerland either. But he has already started to call the Chinese the biggest danger. I can't emphasize on this enough. Lenin, he lived in Zurich. He was trained by Octagon. The best way to control the opposition is to lead it ourselves. So I conclude, as soon as the fair aristocracy detects a dangerous movement, they will try and seek control over it through infiltration, as it happened with Christianism, National Socialism, Communism, Hippie Flower Power Movement and Info Warrior Truther Movement. And the moment they control it, they will use it against us through internal cleansings of the original leaders, as the original Christians were persecuted by Rome before taking over with the Catholic Church, the Bolshevik cleansings, Hitler's 1934 Night of the Long Knives, guillotine beheadings of the French revolutions, and the killing of truth and info warriors as Bill Cooper, Rick Clay, and many others. So they can be replaced with the Hitlers and the Alex Jones demagogue controller agents of the fair aristocracy. Apparently, I'm on their hit list, or should I say shit list, too. So copy all my vids for future generations and spread them all over and show the world about Octagon in the Alps, the base of all evil.